And joining me now is Christopher Bedford, senior editor at The Federalist and co-founder of Right Forge. Chris, welcome back. Always so good to see you. Going into the State of the Union tonight, President Biden is facing a record low approval rating of 41%. That's according to a new Rasmussen poll. That said, how much of a challenge do you think it will be now for him to sell his message to the American people?
I think he's going to have a pretty difficult time. He's had a difficult time so far in office trying to really communicate that message to the American people. What he was elected on, the uniting aspects he was elected on, the shutting down COVID but not shutting down the economy aspects, the adults are back in charge kind of thing, the message to Vladimir Putin that was supposed to send. All of that policy, all those promises lie in wreckage now in front of him. And the State of the Union is supposed to be a time where you can really pull out all the pomp and circumstance, really use the bully pulpit to try and reach the American people, taking advantage of the grandiosity of that chamber with both the House and the Senate in attendance, Supreme Court and the generals in attendance, usually with a lot of guests ever since Ronald Reagan started that policy, and without masks. Now, originally, Nancy Pelosi, the speaker, was saying that there would only be 50 members that were allowed in there. She's since backtracked on that, which I think is a good idea for Democrats. And now she's saying that they're not going to have to wear masks, which is something that they had to do in the Capitol until she just announced that yesterday. And the strange thing about that is all this is going on. There are military blockades, as you mentioned, around the Capitol. There's fences around the Capitol. There's no protests showing up. Suddenly there's no masks. Suddenly there's full attendance. But just a few blocks away, five-year-olds in D.C. public schools are forced to wear their masks every day. So while they may try to say there's some kind of victory over COVID and their policies have worked and try to rewrite history on that, parents are still struggling with schools that refuse to be on the same page.
Yeah, that's for sure. I want to go back to what's going to be said tonight. You know, in the State of the Union, Ukraine, as we know, is expected to be front and center. What else do you expect him to say, or what do you want to hear from the president?
I expect him to say that there's going to be a victory over COVID, that their policies, the president's policies, have worked, that COVID is defeated. This is somewhat of a rewriting of history. Right now, there are lower cases and positives throughout the country. It's about the same hospitalization. It's just the American people, and the polls have shown, have said, we're sick of this. We're no longer going to live our lives like this, and these policies haven't been helping us. I think he's going to try and claim credit for that and say that this was a good thing. He's also going to try and say that despite the inflation concerns they're having, take credit for having the economy that's been coming back. And it has been coming back as people have been slowly returning to work. I don't know how much his policies have contributed to that, but he will try to say that. And he'll try, I think, to assure the American people regarding the Ukrainian situation that, as he was saying from the very beginning, when they unelected Trump and took control, now the adults are here, now some good policy decisions are going to be made. That's going to be a tough sell as well because he's got a lot going on and Ukraine is right now far outside of U.S. control.
Yeah, and Chris, as you noted, obviously a number of challenges we're facing right now. Do you think President Biden, you know, will use tonight, though, as an opportunity to unite the country? Can he do that?
I think he'll use it as an attempt to. It's pretty basic. Even when you saw President Barack Obama, who was very different politics from Ronald Reagan, he would use a lot of Reagan-esque terms during his State of the Union's addresses to try and become more of a united figure. Instead, he'd read Reagan's biography and really respected the way he spoke. Recently, of late, the Democrats have been getting away from that and have been more confrontational phase toward those people who disagree with them, dehumanizing the unvaccinated, for example. I think President Joe Biden plays best when he's a uniting message and could try to come back to that. Usually, the State of the Union is not a place for barbed partisan attacks. Of course, so far, this administration has been different from others.
Yeah, I want to get your final thoughts on the State of the Union. And what else do you expect to hear tonight?
Well, it's going to be interesting to see a president without guests. So he can't point to people and really put a face on things the way the presidents have basically relied on since Ronald Reagan brought that trick to play to put a face on the policies and those people who are being helped. Or as President Trump memorably in his final State of the Union gave a Medal of Honor to Rush Limbaugh in that tearful moment. I don't think he's not going to be able to rely on that because they're banned from it. So it's going to be a layout of his policy agenda and essentially the case for the midterm elections and why Democrats deserve to be reelected. But it's going to be a tough case to make. He's not going to have all the tools available to him that his predecessors have had.
Well, Chris, thank you so much for your time. Always great to get your input. We appreciate it.
Thank you.